Hey folks, I'm VynxarTV again, take another look at Clockwork Empire, a game by Gaslam Games, and since the last time we've been playing, the game has changed quite a lot. And before we go any further, I'm just going to make a quick reminder, so Clockwork Empire is a colonial management game, which is still on beta, so beware the game which is not finished, and will be improved over time, so let's just make a new game, and let's just show you that. So we've got a new map, which is going to give us a bunch of choice where to begin with. So we've got places which are going to be of different biomes. And if you just take a look, can I remove that? Not so much. But there is other places which are going to be unlocked when you are going to reach a certain amount of population on your primary map. So we're going to go around, I'm going to just move the panel maybe on the right. And you can see there is plenty of maps you can just take a look at. And I believe certain areas are going to be maybe much more dangerous. This is probably why these areas are not possible to reach right now. So I might want to go with, let's say, we've got ocean, swamp, temperate, moist, there's plenty of different biomes here. But maybe there is something which is going to be a bit easier to begin with. So maybe, let's see, which one do we want to go for? We can also see the dominant foreign presence, which might be important at some point, but maybe not at the beginning. And what are we going to go for? Alpine, temperate, moist, there is plenty of good areas here. I might want to go with high prairie maybe, and alpine, temperate, maybe this one, a regular forest. It's going to be less interesting though. So what would be the most interesting? There is a boreal forest here. Let's go for this one, seems to be cool. I'm not going to go for the jolly, which is probably a mistake, but let's just make my own choice and die as I wish, kind of. I'm always starving in this game. I hope it's not going to happen again. So, here we go. So, welcome to the frontier. Your travel have seen you skimming over murky rivers and rainforest, and you find you've rather come to enjoy the adventure. Your advanced party is ready, and it's time to get to work on expanding. The empire is just overflowing with workers ready to be shipped off to the colony with available housing. You decide you're going to spend all your time indoor. You remember your mentor's advice on colonial management. Bring lots of cash to grease the cog of bureaucracy. Now bring civilization or something roughly akin to the colony and glory to the empire. Okay, let's begin. What is very cool is now the, I don't know if it's been there for long, but we can actually use WSAQ touch to move around, and it's working properly because I had a strange bridge which was just pushing the camera all the time to the right, I don't know why, and I was not able to redeem that. Anyway, let's just begin. The game is a bit different than before. I'm going to pause it so we can just take a look around a bit. And it's not working as before, where we are not able to choose the kind of team our overseers are going to be doing. You can just take a look at their skills. I think all the UI has been worked quite a bit, and we can see at a glimpse what they are good at, how they feel, the happiness, desperate stuff, and what is going to be predominant here. We can also get a look at their memories, their journal and all. It's just all in this little screen, and it's just, you know, very well. It's just very well made. Anyway, let's go around. There is also a thing, we've got now a workplace capacity which is going to prevent us from building too many buildings, which might be a good thing because it takes a bit of time to make these. And we've got also a provision here which we can see, which is going to tell us how much time we can survive without caring too much about money, about food. And then we've got disturbance point. So when we're going to build, we're going to disturb the place and we're going to get trouble for that. So let's just begin to build stuff. I'm going to be doing firstly a carpentry, which is really one of the most important building I need to build at first. So we can make planks, and there is a bit of work to do here. We are lacking a proper place to build our base because I need to flatten the place. I might want to ask them to do that right away. Let's just make the place a bit better, and let's see. I might want to go from here and push it, and do it. I'm not sure it's a good idea to make such a big area, but I really need a big place to make my base, so I'm going to let them do their stuff, and I'm going to add a big storage to begin with, if I can, somewhere around, maybe here, or maybe it would be more responsible to put it around here, I'm not sure. Oh, maybe just over there would be fine. Yes, here is good. I'll just put the storage here. So they're going to begin to move all the stuff in there. And I also get a few small stockpile. We've got also new things. I'm not sure the landmine was there already, but it seems to be quite a cool thing to add around my base. I've got also lamps and big lamps and even bigger lamps here. I can plant the things back, like grass or shrubbery or flowers. And what else do we have? We've got all our models, which are still there. But there is a difference. We cannot put any model into any workshop. Now we need to stick to some kind of categories. So I cannot put beds into workshop anymore. I need a proper place to make my people sleep. So it's going to be more difficult to make these beds at first, but maybe it will be more efficient at some point, because every building is going to get a quality level, so you will need to keep these things high if you want to make this thing work properly. So what are we going to do first? Yes, the carpentry. So where do we want to establish carpentry? There is not so much space around. I might want maybe to bring it here. There is just enough space to make it. I think I'm going to make it maybe 8x8, might be good enough. Let's do it here. I might need to add a door like here. I'm going to make one of these bench. I think I might want to go for two. It's going to be easier because each bench is going to give you a building queue. So it's much better to have a bench so you can decide what you are going to do next. And I might even add a few windows, but maybe it's too early. I don't want to begin to burn all my planks yet. I will need these. And as you can see, if you just take a look here, I've got now one workplace. So if I want to make more, I will need to get more population. And I might want to begin to grow stuff if I don't want to starve to death. So I'm going to add one of these around here. I want these things to be close to the storage. It's going to be easier to protect them and also to move the goods around. Or I could go here. I'm not sure. Okay, let's go here. I will just flatten the place and add a second one here. But I don't want to add too many because, you see, I'm taking also one more workplace with the farm. And the gathering of everything is working a bit differently. Before, we were just making that, and you were choosing with a little menu what we were going to do. Now we are having four icons down there. We've got chop trees, and you do that, and it's going to establish which tree you want to cut. It's much faster than before, and I can go around and just click on all these trees, so it's going to be possible for us to gather a bunch pretty quickly. There is also a mining tool here to remove all the things which are on the way here. Oh, okay. Can I get the last one? Oh, it's done already. And I might want to remove that because it's a bit in the way. I might want to remove these as well. Okay, so we've got plenty of things to work on. And then we've got the foraging stuff. And if you just hover around, you can see the thing which are going to be lit. So this is the little mushroom here. I'm taking these. There is even more around. I might want to go and get these. There is also berries somewhere here and here as well. So I think there is, on the average, a lot more food around. I got some here. So I've been asking so many things. I'm not sure my team are going to be able to do that. And another thing which is different is that we are not beginning with any soldiers. So it's quite dangerous, and I hope we might be able to fix that soon. I need to build a barrack if we want to be safe again. So to build a barrack, I will need, let's see, I've got everything, so I might want to begin and do the barrack already. But I'm not sure. Oh, I could do it because it's not requiring any planks, so just a little barrack is not going to armors. Oh, look at this. We've got deers. Zebra deers, kind of. And where do I want to put the barrack? I'm going to maybe put it here. I don't really need the big one because there is not so much to put in there yet. But I might want to give me a bit extra space on the side, just like this. Maybe I could just push it a bit further. I like the fact that we can just edit this shape like this, so we can make a shape which is going to be a bit different. Except I've been failing a bit here, but okay, it might be going that way. Let's do it. We need 12 logs. I'm going to add a little door over there. And I might want to add a few windows around so we can see if there is any creatures which are roaming and trying to stay unseen. Alright. Let's add a bit over there as well, just to be sure. Okay, so I've got now a barrack and a carpentry, and I really need a kitchen. I need to make a kitchen right away. So if I want to be able to feed my population, I've got a bunch of loaf of bread, and I've got also a bit of sausage, but it would be much better if I was able to cook these. So let's see, we need to go into public service. Nah, we want a kitchen, and to make this kitchen, what do we have? I don't have so much space. I don't want to spread my buildings too much, because I also want to make a wall to protect us, because enemy tend to be a bit more aggressive than before, I think. I'm not really sure about that, but I've been noticing that they were attacking quite a lot, especially fishmen, which were definitely deadly. I'm going to check how far I'm going with the flattening of the train. Where is the little panel? I don't see it anymore. It might be around, just don't see it. Oh, over there. So, oh, am I not flattening the right? Not so much. Okay, let's just add a bit. Where is it going? It's stopping at the carpentry. So if I want to flatten the place a bit more, I want it to begin at the carpentry. So let's just do it here. Let's just remove these holes. And I'm going to go and deal with that one as well. Okay, I'm going to stop here. Okay, so I've got plenty to do. And I might want to bolster a bit the flattening team. So who is going to deal with that? I think it might be that guy. He's building stuff, so I'm going to add two people, so it's going to work a bit faster. And I think he might be doing the flattening next. Is he? And I might want to assign somebody to the carpentry. And what is cool is that when you are going to assign people, now you can see their skills. I don't think it was the case already, so you don't need to choose somebody first, and then you can also see how many people are working with him. So quite handy. So I'm going to assign Mr. Chenworth to the carpentry, and I'm going to ask him to do stuff when they're sleeping inside, because they are just much safer that way. And we are still building this thing. To clear the train, and there is plenty of stuff here. And I will need to assign somebody. Let's see. I need to see their skills. I will just take it out. Check it out after a while. But for now, they're pretty happy. It's not going to last. My colony often end up a bit sad or angry. But we'll do our best to keep it good until I can't. Okay, so everybody's working. I'm going to speed up a bit the time. Oh, we've got our first workshop. I'm going to ask the guy to make a few things. I need planks, obviously. So I'm going to ask for maybe, let's go and press shift to make more. And I'm going to ask for 100 planks, so he's not going to stop. But I'm going to change a bit the pretty, so he's going to make planks all the time. But I need him to do other stuff also, so I'm going to ask him to do the assembly workbench first. I will need a bench, like 5. So if he's not able to do the workbench, he will do the planks. Seems to be a good idea. Now he's working on that, Ilfred. And we are almost done with this. Almost. What's happening here? Let's just pause the game. Oh, there is a save. I think the save is slightly slower. Not slower, faster than before, which is quite nice. And let's take a look at this strange artifact. So digging day in and day out is enough to numb anyone's mind. But Sewell Rustler feels something different today, a buzzing in the back of his skull that defies explanation. With sudden fury, he strikes at the rock. The buzz grows louder. Something is there, calling out with a voice that is no voice. The sound is intense, now deafening, and then, with a final strike, silence. The rebel falls away to reveal a strange object covered in symbols. Sewell Usher has never seen it like before, yet it feels comforting. An unfamiliar grin comes to his face, the symbol it is time. What is this thing? You feel yourself smile too. What is this thing about? Let's just take a look at this. So, strange artifact, where is it? Let's dismiss the alert and just check on the artifact. So, Sewell is working on this and the artifact should be in, kind of. Let's just speed up a bit, see if it's going to actually find something. Might want to check on the guy. So, humbled by the infinite terror of the cosmos. Okay. So it's increasing despair and reducing happiness and anger, but it's increasing fear much more. Okay, so it has quite a huge effect on the guy. And let's go back. I was in post, so it's why it's not advancing so much. Even though we were in a multiply by 2 time speed. And here it goes. What is this thing? A fishy idol. It's quite expensive, it seems. Even though I don't really know the value of things. And yes, it's quite expensive. It feels way to the touch. Okay. It's a forbidden artifact. We'll need to sell it. I'm going to designate at trade good. Hopefully it will not bring anything dangerous to the village. And let's check. So the barracks seems to be done, and I might want to assign somebody. Do we have anybody which is going to be good? Yes, V. Aaron Smith. Who's the guy? He might, or she might change clothes soon. Aaron Smith. Victoria Aaron Smith. So where is she? She's behind the door. I cannot see her, but she might be good at what she's doing. So let's take a look. She's very good at military skills, so she's perfect for the job. I might want to sign a few more people, but it's not an emergency. She's well fed. Okay, everything seems to be fine for now. We'll need to make it better. And I need to sign somebody to the farm if I wanted to walk at any time. So do we have any good farm around? We've got a whistle, which is already flattening the terrain, so I'm not going to ask him to do so. I'm going to ask Sewell Wrestler. He's not really good with that, nah. So, who do I want to ask? Brethren's team? He's good at smithing. Okay, I'm just going to change the team. Seems to me Civil Wrestler is doing the same job here. So I might want to assign a whistle to the farming and maybe change a bit this thing. So let's remove these guys, and I'm going to give them to Sewell, which is actually doing all the heavy work here, clearing the place and all. And I might want to check again if I can make the kitchen, because the kitchen is going to be very important and I need to do it quickly. I could do it here maybe. It might work. It's not perfect, but it might work. So let's just make an 8x8 little house. I'm lacking things, but I'm not going to care too much because I will have some at some point. Let's just give them a bit more space. I do not have enough money. Okay. Can I not add a bit more? Seems not to be the case. And here? I can here. So it's strange. Let's just rotate a bit, see what's wrong. Oh, I do know what's wrong. There is a block which I cannot. Actually, it's not that bad for a kitchen. I'm going to go with that kind of shape. And then, we need planks, we don't have so much. I might want to add a door so we can actually enter the place. Okay, I need also a few windows. Don't want to do this already. Okay, I need the quality to be good. I'm going to add 2 windows at the back. Going to make a big one, kind of, and let's do the same on each side. Maybe it's going to be a bit strange, but we'll see that. Oh, this one seems to be fine with just one. Maybe it is the case with this one already. No, it's bigger because we are lacking one little block over there, and I'm going to add one window at the front, and there is also closed windows, which might help at some point. Quality? Oh, it's not improving quality. Okay, anyway, we're just going to do this nonetheless. Okay, so the kitchen is in motion, but if we don't have any oven, it's not going to work. So there is one more building we need to do if we want to make it run. And it is going to be the brickery? The ceramic workshop. And do we have the room to do it? I might want to go for it, but it seems to be a bit too far. I'm going to maybe add it here. I don't really need a big one. Still, I think the modules are going to be a bit big, so I might want to... is there enough room here? Can I just... It's really a bad... Nah, let's cancel the thing. I don't want to make this thing too close. Except I could actually make a wall in between. Ah, let's just do it again. So let's just make it so that it's going to be that big. Then I'm going to adjust a bit. I'm going to keep maybe two space here. And I'm going to add a bit more room here. So it's going to maybe work a bit better. And slightly more over there. Okay, it seems not that bad. Do I want to add a bit more space here? I might want to do that. Alright, let's go with this. I need to get more matches. And I need to actually add a door or a few other things here. The ceramics kiln is really required. So I might want to add a bunch here, but I cannot put it if there is... Oh, yes, I can. So where am I going to put this thing? Maybe over there. Yeah, let's go with this. I will have many more to put in there, so I'm going to... I could put two of these. Is it a good thing? I'm not sure. Let's go with two. I'm going to make a nice chimney here. Let's just do it that way. And I will maybe add windows later on because I'm running low on planks. And am I building planks? You know what, I'm just going to reduce the priority here. Planks are more important. And I might want also to assign somebody to the carpentry. Maybe it's not an emergency, I'm going to stick to that for now. I would prefer to keep the last workplace for a second farm. But I feel like I should now begin to think about making a little house for my people. A laborer bank house. And I don't have the room. Where do I want to put this? Maybe I don't want to make it too big, but there is still not enough space to do it. Even if I was to make a little one, it would not fit. I could make a L-shaped staff. I'm not sure. What I know is that I should begin to think about defense, and I might want to begin to build high gabion, let's say, in between these two. So we're not going to be surprised by beast. I could do a bench over there as well. Oh, we are being pursued by some beast, which we might shoot at some point. Let's just... So what is this thing? We've got one which is already dead, it seems. And can we... Yes, we can butcher the beast. So it's going to be good for us. Still, they are quite dangerous. I hope they are not going to kill any of our guys. Victoria seems to be following closely, even though she's got two names. I can click on the names. Can I? Yes, so maybe it's easier to click on their name than to click on the people. So the beast has left. And my kitchen, is it being built? I hope so, but I cannot be sure. And is several still... Oh, yeah, the second one is down as well. So let's butcher the beast. And let's speed up a bit. Alright. How much... where is it going? I might want to bring it back with you. So we've got 12 rows to take. I need to cook these. I've got also a bunch of sausages, I still have a bit of bread, I've got a bit of grape, but not that much, and a bunch of fungus. Okay, good. I will need to cook these. But I still need to find a place for these guys to sleep. plenty of food for at least 4 days, and I've got 2 of these, good, so we are safe on this side, but I definitely need to add a bunch more. Let's do it that way for now. I will just try to link these two things when we'll be able to do so. And I just want to let one entrance. It's going to be easier for my soldier to protect the place. It's not going to be that easy. Especially if they don't take care of this. Oh, there's one more. We need to be careful. Where is the thing? Can I ask my guys to take care of it? Not so much. Where is Victoria? She's over there, protecting the guy, which are just flattering the place here. Maybe it was not a good idea. Maybe we could just remove this thing. It's not an emergency, it would be much more efficient. No, it's going to be useful. Just not about. Oh, yes, there is so many things to do. And we're being attacked again. And you can even go into this house. There is. How many do we have around? I might want to make a wall over there. So they're not going to be able to reach us so much. I'm going to make a wall over there. And just treat it a bit, and I might want to, because I'm going to ask them to make a few of these so we can actually shoot through if needed. And I might want to wait for them to take care of this so I can keep going on the wall. I just add a bunch over there as well. We'll see where we go from here. Okay, so I've got a bunch of things to do. We might want to add, let's say, something very important. We need an assembly workbench to make stuff in there. So let's just add one of these over there. So we're going to be able to actually make cots, so we can give them a place to sleep. How many planks do we have? 11, okay, not bad. And we've got the workbench almost ready, so we've got now... Is it ready? Yes it is, so let's just put this thing up there into the... And we need cots, so let's begin with that. It's the first time I've been trying to make practical bait, as I thought it would be more efficient, but you cannot use objects which are of a quality which is superior to the building you are putting them in. So if you want to make practical beds, you need to make an overseas house. You cannot use it in laborer bunkhouse. It's not working like that. So we need to keep modules within their tier. And I still need some space to make this place even more now. You know, I could do it here and add a little bit of walling here. It might work. Let's go and do this here. Okay, I'm going to add a bunch. I need plenty of logs. I will need to add them to. I need to make this thing big because I've got plenty of worker to make sleep here. So I need to be increase a bit the size of it. And if I was to add a bit more space around here, it would be even better. And I could do the same here. Is it big enough? I'm not sure, but it might be sufficient enough for now. Alright, let's do it that way for now. I'm going to add a door at the front. Where to? Maybe over there. I don't want the door to be too far. Maybe I could add 2 doors like that. It seems to be a bad idea. I'll just not do this one. And I'm not going to build too many things for now. I could build cots already, but I could do it. Yes, I could do it. Let's just do it. I don't need both sides to be accessible, so I can go with that. I'm going to add two over there. How much space do I have? Okay, I could do it that way. And let's just switch a bit. I would prefer to keep the central area for a table and stuff. I need to zoom a bit. Is there a side on this? I'm not sure. I'm going to do the same on the other side if I can. Let's just take a look that way, plus two here, another one here, and I will have enough space, yes, so it's going to work just fine. And I should have enough to begin with. I'm going to not push much further. I will need to add table and chair here, so I can just have a place to... Oh, it's big. It's much bigger than I thought. Nah, it will work. Let's just keep it that way. And let's just speed up this thing. So they're going to finish sleeping soon. And we need to worry about the provision soon. A bit about the provision. And what are we doing here? We've got clay nod here. I might want to remove it. And to remove all the thing. And I also maybe want to clear the train and remove the thing which are not necessary. There's so many work to do to make the place flat enough and properly. Oh, you know what? I might want to cut a few trees. If you want to be able to keep building stuff. I should have enough here. Maybe a bit here as well. Done. I don't know why I've been doing that way. It seems to be too big. Anyway, it will do. I need a big house like this, and I will do a little one later on. What's happening with Victoria here? And oh, is my colony doing that here? So everybody's angry. It's not cool. And there seems to be quite unhappy with the situation here. Yes, very angry. Why are they angry? They feel recklessly endangered. So what I should do here is a bit different. I should just remove the gate which are flooding the place and put them into the team of Victoria, which is bugging, kind of. I don't know why there is no picture here. She's alive. She has a picture. No, she don't have a picture. It's maybe a little bug. Might be the case. I've got a few people which are lacking their picture. Strange, I did not see it the first time. Oh, what's happening? We've got fish people which are coming here. So Owen Shackle has reported sighting a strange, fishy-looking creature. It walked upright like a human, and its eyes gleamed with red intelligence. What shall we do? It's a tough choice, because if I go with the first one, it was probably a bird or an oddly shaped tree. I still didn't see anything. They're going to begin to roam around, and they're going to get into the colony and maybe kill a few people, and I will need to go and shoot them. Or I could just ask them to shoot them on sight, and they might come into assault team. So it's a bad choice in either direction. So I'm going to go and shoot this guy on sight, so I will not be required to ask them later to do so. I don't want this guy anywhere close to my base. Oh, there is a little cute little fox over there. Hope they are not going to shoot it. Because these guys are so cute. Where is she going? So, these guys, they've got pistols to begin with. And we've got a bunch of ammos. We've got very little ammos. I need to worry about this soon. So I need to make... what are we lacking? Planks. Hopefully, we'll do more. And how are we going now? It's getting better, because I've been asking people to... no, it's still not good. Let's take a look. Can I... Oh! Wait, there is no plank because there is no logs. If we don't cut trees, we won't be able to build anything, so I don't need them to cut trees. No, we do have fish people here. And we need to... We need to try to assault them. So they may flee. Okay, it seems to be too late. They are going to bed. They won't care about him anymore. He might steal stuff from us, though. I wonder if the fishy idol is going to protect us or not. Maybe they are just going to pick it up and live with it. Alright, so they are awake and they will soon begin to walk. Which is fine because we've got so many planks. Look at all the things which needs to be built. So many planks required. Let's take a look. Cotton planks. Okay. Oh, what's happening here? Good. We are being visited by a suspicious guy. So, Sewell Wrestler is willing to donate some goods to the colony that they claim fell off the back of an airship under mysterious circumstances. I'm going to just pretend this is normal. Such action damage the colony goods name? Nah, let's not ask questions. An acquired is good. What do we have? I hope it's planks. No, it's not. It's shark and lacquer. Okay. It's not what we need, but... Oh, and maybe there is a bunch of fungus. I'm not sure about that. So the kitchen is not ready. Do we have a team which is actually shopping wood? Yes, we do have people which are doing that. Two people, Cordelia and Leland. What are they? Are they overseeing anything? So Cordelia here is chopping trees, and what are they good at? Can I just click on her? Yes, again. So she's good at stone walking, and Leland here is good at stone walking as well, plus smithing. Okay, interesting. Why are they fleeing? Kind of. No, they're not fleeing. They are just maybe very, very sad. Or just getting crazy. Let's just take a look. Cordelia, what's happening with you? She's just very, very sad. And if we take a look at my people here... Okay, it's better. They are not angry anymore. They are just sad. And I've got even a few people which are happy. And probably it is because of the... They feel completely safe. Which is going to give us a huge boost. But we're going to lack food soon, so they might just go back to being angry. We'll see. I got plenty of food here, which is laying around. I don't know why they are just leaving these things here. Maybe I need a place to store the food or something. Okay, so wood is coming back. My buddy are walking. I might want to change a bit the order, because planks are more important than cots. And... Can we just dispose of this guy? Just attack the guy. And he's fighting now. But we are more than he is. And oh, come on. Oh, I was mistaken. Here they come. There is a team of fishermen which are going to attack our village. And they might not be friendly anymore. They might even destroy stuff. Come on guys, you need to save that poor Owen here, which is taking damage. He might die at some point. Oh, they're attacking our buildings, and there is even more of these guys. And they've got blunt weapons. I don't know what these things are. Just, blunt weapons. Let's slow down a bit so we can just see what's happening here. Hopefully the guns are doing quite a good job here, but I will definitely need to have more ammo. And... Okay, another one. Let's kill them all. See, I will need walls. Did they kill somebody? I think they did. Not cool. Hopefully we'll get reinforcement at some point. Okay. Done. was not without harm, but it's done, nonetheless. And we have now space to put these things. Not so much, we still need to work on this. And I'm going to add a bunch of these here, so they won't go any further. And can we? Yes, I'm going to close the place here. It's too dangerous. So they won't go that way. All good. Let's keep going. So the maze seems to be growing slowly but surely. We'll be able to cook this soon. But not before these two things are built, and then I can make my own oven. Let's speed up a bit. Alright, let's go. So night is happening, and I really need to get some reinforcement. Oh, we are getting a bit more wood. How much logs do we have? 58! Okay, we might be able to do some planks now. Are we being attacked? We need a graveyard. Oh, of course we need... I forgot. Completely forgot. Let's just add one. And where was it? Is it not here? It was here. Oh, it is. I just did not see it. And we're going to put it somewhere close, but not too close. Let's go maybe around here. No, maybe a bit more south. Like here. So we can bury our dead people. So let's see, can I click on a... Oh, they're taking care of it. And we need to dispose of this corpse. We cannot detect these because we don't have a naturalist, I think. Nor a naturalist office. Oh, laborers arrive. Good, we are going to get reinforcement here. So, recent reports of your colony progress and more importantly ample housing. I've drawn immigrant to your colony. Approaching from the border you see one laborer, which is going to, yes, fill the... The laborer seems to be doing well, as befits those bravely bringing the wilderness to a new colony. I need to build an additional house and I will have more workforce. So I've got one more guy, so I'm going to assign him to my soldiers. And as soon as possible we'll try to reinforce the barracks. We might want to remove these things. Let's take a look. And we might also want to forage this bush for food. Okay, I need to ask them to remove these bodies, and as I was about to say, it's not that easy. You cannot use the clear terrain things, it's not going to work. At least not on these guys. Maybe it is, I think it was not, but let's try, let's just try. If they remove all these bodies, it might work. It's not obviously the case. No, I think I need to click on the guys. They're going to remove the blood, but maybe not the bodies. So I need to click on the bodies. On the bodies, please. Oh, we are saving a bit. Let's just slow down a bit. So I need to click on these guys and click on dump fish, bears, and corpse. If you want to remove them from our colony. Oh, maybe not. I don't know. Let's just take a look around. Let's speed up a bit. Because I think I did not click on this one, but on the other one. Anyway, so... I was still lacking planks. We need to assign somebody here, but not yet. And you know what, I might want to speed up the thing. I'm going to remove one of my guys from the solid gyms, and I'm going to assign him to the carpentry. Where is it? Who's working in the carpentry here? Let's just take a look. It is Chain Wars. Okay, so Chain Wars. is over there, so let's just assign a second guy. So we might want to ask for a second... okay, more planks. Ask for 100 planks. No, 100. And done. So I can have two people which are going to work on planks now. It's going to speed up a bit the process. And we might be able to finish things in a timely manner. Because we are beginning to lack food. And it's not good. Might want to ask them to fridge a bit more though. Ah, fish people patrol, not cool. We're going to be attacked soon. There is so much food around, I should just take it. And cook it then. Where are these guys? I hope there is not too many because I've got only two guys now which are just fighting our enemies back. I wonder, why are they able to... Oh, because these walls are not on yet, so there is basically no defense here, and here is there. So despair is quite high here. Oh, one more fish people here. How far are we on the plank stuff? 7, not that bad. We might even finish some of these buildings. Okay, what do we have here? What is it bringing? Crab damage, tragic death. Who died? Oh, come on. Is it our super soldier? Hope not. I think it might be Victoria. Hope not, but just take a look at our team. Victoria is still alive, but she has now one less people with her, I think. Yes, she's now all alone. She has no... other worker with her. And as we are creating more disturbance, we are going to get more attacked. So obviously it's not working to clear the place. I'm just going to add them to dump the fish person. I don't see them anymore. What's happening here? A strange meteor, a strange silvery blue meteor was spotted blazing across night sky. Then a thunderous roar awoke the entire colony. The meteor must have impacted very close by. We should investigate this. Where should it be? Because I believe this kind of meteor could be quite valuable here. We'll need to search around at some point. And here they come again. Attacking us, harassing us, and trying to kill Leland. Come on guys, just shoot the beast. I'm going to ask them to do so if they are not willing to. No, Victoria is still shooting the guy, and there is another one who's coming for Victoria. I hope she's not going to die. When I need more people, I obviously need so much more people. Do not kill Cordelia, please. Oh, it's not running as fast as before. So how are we dealing with these? I've been obviously asking too many buildings at the same time. And Victoria seems to be not doing so bad, but she might be in trouble. Because there is two guys which are really fighting her. And even though she's good, maybe she's not that good. You know what, I might want to unassign this guy here. Did she die? Oh, come on, she died. It's too late. I would prefer not to die in this episode, it would be stupid. Have I seen it? Yes and no. But who do I want to assign here? Anybody might be good enough. But there are no good here. Present team, is he assigned to anything? I don't think so. Let's just assign Leland, maybe. No, not Leland. They're quite good with stuff. I don't want to lose them. Are they trying to kill us? Don't think they are trying to kill us anymore. We might have reinforcements soon. We are very low on provision here. I got a few here, but not so much. They're going to get a bit crazy because we don't have any more defense here, so it might be even more dangerous than before. And we'd bury Victoria, which is a shame because she was a very good soldier. Come on, it's difficult to click on these guys. Why are we not building this thing? I think we might have... Oh, we need plenty of planks. So many planks. But we're almost done on this. Let's speed up a bit. I hope, as we're going to recruit new people, we might survive. Make cuts complete. We've got 9 of these, so when the building is going to be done, we'll be able to welcome everybody in this building. It'll take some time. It's quite a big building. Crop damage. Do I have no more people which are working here? I do have somebody. But he seems not to be very concerned with the thing. I don't like to have body decaying here, though. And what's happening here? Why are they fleeing like this? Oh, they are eating these bodies. Oh, I don't want to let this thing happen. I know there is deadly thing which are going to happen if I'm not throwing these guys away. Why do I still have Victoria and Errant Miss here? She's dead. She cannot be there. I've been seeing pretty funny things here. What are you doing here? Need to dam them. Oh. We've got a bit of water here. When you don't bury people, let's say their soul come to other colonists and ask them to bury them. It's pretty fun. I like it. They come as a skeleton. A ghost skeleton or something like that. We've been attacked by these things? These things are just eating our crops. We need to take care of them. Come on, guys. Cordelia, please take care of these guys. They are eating our crops. We won't be able to feed ourselves if this is... Come on, I need to dump him somewhere else. Not here. They need to be buried somewhere. Now we're getting less and less provision. And what are we working on right now? More planks. But it's not going to be enough, is it? We've got all the... all the stone necessary. But we are still lacking the planks. Yes, we do. But it seems to be increasing, slowly but surely. 11 and some more are coming, so... it'll be possible soon to finish these buildings. How much do we have here? 11? It's not more. No, just 11. Strange. Okay, this building is going to be done soon. Certain planks. And growing. 15. Almost enough to make a building. And I think we'll need soon another storage. We can go with a few small ones. Maybe it's going to be much more efficient in some ways. Might want to even just put this thing here and there. And store a bunch of stuff on these area, which are not going to be used for anything else. And we have more storage area. Nah, not yet. Let's just keep it that way. It's already plenty of place to fill. And this area is not even finished. No, it's not. We are being attacked by a fish people or two, but my guy seems to be dealing with that. With despair. But efficiency. Dump their corpse. So many. What's happening here? Oh, we've got plenty of people which are coming here. Very nice. Do we have an embassy? I'm not sure. One overseer and one laborer. Very good. Let's just take a look. I need to see if there are any good. Let's just take a look at their skills. I need to assign an overseer, and I would prefer him to be good. Oh! Quarter clock. He seems to be quite good. And I might want to assign him somebody else. She's quite good. She's Linera Quarterclock. And this is a salty regiment. I like it. I hope she's going to survive. And somebody's mad and is in despair. Oh, mad is it right now. Of criminal element. Okay, interesting. Generating spirit and exotic. Okay. Hopefully they will get better. I think we are beginning to build this one. Cool, so we are going to begin to... Oh, it's not done yet. There is so much work to do here. Still, when the ceramic workshop is going to be done and the kitchen, it's going to go much better. I might want to even ask them to cut a few more trees, because we might be in need of these. Where is going? Okay, they are just bringing these things far away from the town. What do we have here? Oh, some kind of cemetery for fish people. Do we have more than one? That seems to be the case. Well, just bring these guys out of our city. Everybody's going crazy here. I need to begin Oh, this one is done. And I need to assign somebody to it. I got no good cook, so let's assign Leland Twist. And I might want to also make quality is good here. Let's take a look. Kitchen. I obviously want an assembly workbench, but it's not really an emergency because I won't be able to make much with it. But I need a stone oven, which is much more important. And I'm going to put it. Over there. It was difficult, but it's working. I'm going to put two of these so I can begin to cook properly. What is this going on? The reform citadel. Somebody's going back to normal. And we've got zero provision. Not good at all. But we've got fruits here. They could eat that. And fungus. We need to just prepare these. When we're going to be done with these, we might be able to... Oh, somebody's very happy here. I don't know why. It's a mess. Okay, everybody's sleeping. Except for Sewell, which is really dedicated to his work and which is going to try to make this huge. And I think this is probably the thing which is putting me in trouble. A low-class house. Yeah, so I've really been building too big here. 62 logs. What was I thinking about? This size is good enough. It's easy to build. It does not require so much materials. I need to finish this house so I can just prevent them from going that way. Because right now my defense is really, really bad. And can we actually build a few more of these? Not so much, we still need to work on this. I could keep going a bit that way. But I could also make a building around here, so I might not want to go that far. Not enough timber. Okay, if we don't have so much timber, I might not want to build this thing. And I could probably destroy it with... There might be an option here. No, it's not working here. Don't have any option to destroy that. Do we have anybody which is actually working on this? Oh, what's happening here? So let's just slow down a bit. Representative of the of Lotto Dictator mechanical minions were invited to the capital, charming and being charmed in return by clockwork and aristocrats, minister barons of the industry. Relation between the Empire and the Republic mechanic have improved as a result. Okay. We cannot do much right now, but we will probably need to make a foreign affair office at some point. I think we can do things like this around. I've got a trade office, a foreign office here, which will be probably one of the things we need. And let's just go around quickly, because I will not be able to do all these buildings, but we've got plenty of things to build. And I will probably try to make a few more of these in the next episode, if I'm not dead yet. Because there's plenty of things to build, and it's quite an interesting settlement to try to make survive. Okay, so now we've got the little lower class out, which is done. We are having one cut here, but they are going to have much more sooner. It's a pretty it's a zero quality class house, so we'll need to make it better at some point. And they are going to begin to work on this soon, hopefully. How much planks do we have? Not that much, basically zero. And I think we've got zero logs as well, so we'll need to cut wood a bit at some point. Anyway, let's just slow down a bit of time. Guys, I think we'll need to make another video to explore a bit more the new option of this new update. So guys, thank you for watching, and if you like the video, if you do, please leave a like, a comment or subscribe, and I'll thank them, guys. Have fun!